Why is this so hard? Why is this so hard? Oh man, why is this so hard to just do this simple fucking video? I'm having so much trouble doing this video, and I don't know why. It's so simple and so straight to the point that I'm having trouble doing it. I mean, I pretty much say the same intro I always do. Hey guys, it's Man of Justice 21 here, and considering what this video is about, I continue with bringing you another health update video. But the thing is, I know what I have to say, I just don't know how to say it. Because here's the thing. Hold on. Starting to feel cold, thank God. Here's the thing. You guys pretty much know what this health update video is about, as long as you guys are pretty much paying attention to my channel and saying that I've been live streaming the last couple days. Because if you guys remember, a week ago, let me see, what day was it? Calendar, let's see. I don't remember what day it was. Probably July 4th to the 5th. One of those days, I think it was. I'm not entirely sure. No. It was Friday, I think. I think it was Friday the 8th. No, I don't remember. It's got to be the 4th or the 5th of July. July 4th or July 5th. I told you guys I was pretty much going to be going into surgery the week after, which was July 15th. And you guys saw how freaked out I was. Like, I was extremely freaked out because that was pretty much one of my biggest fears that I never wanted to do surgery. I honestly just feared it so much. I feared the fact, not the fact, but the thought that if I were to go into surgery, I might not wake up. And that was one of my biggest fears. That and flying on an airplane, which I conquered, I think like 2 years ago. But yeah, I was freaking out badly. But this video is pretty much to show you guys that I'm fine. Well, like I said, if you guys have been paying attention to my channel, you guys have pretty much seen that I've been fine since the surgery because I've been live streaming. But I wanted to make a specific video showing or telling you guys that I'm fine. Pretty much the scar that I have is about 4 to 5 inches on my back. It's pretty big. I don't really like looking at it. But the funny thing is, and I told my parents this too. Well, I told my mom this. I feel a bit more grown up that I actually went through with it. And the fact that I actually conquered my fear on surgery and flying on an airplane. And here's the thing. The 2 days beforehand, I was actually given the choice. My mom talked to the surgeon. I think I mispronounced that. But my mom talked to my doctor or surgeon, because he was my surgeon, and asked him, does he need to do this? Because we were pretty much told it could be, it's most likely fatty tissue, and it's fatty tissue is not really anything to worry about. And he's like, yeah, he doesn't have to do it. It's nothing to worry about. It's nothing dangerous or anything like that. So I was given the choice to go with the surgery or not to go with the surgery. And I chose to go with it. I have no idea why, but I pretty much decided to go for the surgery because, for all I knew, it might not have been fatty tissue. It could have been something else, something worse. So it was better to just get it taken out. But after he took it out, he did tell my parents that it was most likely fatty tissue. Just because he saw it, he had it taken out and all that. I will say though, the day of the surgery was not fun at all, because I woke up with a very bad headache. And when it comes to headaches with me, it can be pretty bad to the point where I'd rather shoot myself. And it didn't help any that, actually, I will say, the headache actually calmed me down because I was more focused on that than the surgery. But when it came down to, getting undressed, putting on the hospital gown, and laying in the bed waiting for everything to be done, that's where everything started to kick in. So I was freaking out. I didn't want my parents in there because the woman that was there, she asked me, do you have anyone out there waiting for you? I was like, yeah, my mom, my dad, my sister. And she asked me if I wanted them to come in to see me. And I was like, no. Because to be completely honest, my mother can make things a lot worse than they need to be. And my dad, he makes a lot of jokes to try and cheer people up. And that's certain moments you don't really need to make jokes. No offense to him. It's just when I'm freaking out about something and I'm fearing for my life, I don't need to hear jokes. So, but my mom, she makes things worse because, mainly because she's my mom, and when she starts talking about something like this, it freaks me out and it makes me sad and makes me cry. And personally, I don't like it when people see me cry, and it takes a lot for me to cry. And pretty much what has made me cry is either a really good plot that has a really good sad ending. It's very well written and it's extremely sad. Or it's something that makes me fear for my own life. Like when I went on my first plane ride, I cried. And on the surgery, I cried. I was very afraid. I didn't want them to see me like that. But eventually I calmed down. I don't think they gave me a sedative at all, because they did say they weren't going to put anything in me until it was time for everything to happen. But eventually I calmed down for some reason, and I was like, sure, let them in. And my mom came in, pretty much tried to reassure me everything was going to be okay. And what really didn't help me at all though was at that surgery place. On the ceiling, and I even looked to the left and I saw a little bit of a little bit of the corner of other people who were getting surgeries on the on where the. It's hard to. Basically, for when I was looking up, because that's all I could see was when I just looked straight ahead, was on the ceiling. There was like a certain ceiling tile that had three animals looking at you with the sky above, and. In my head, all I could think about was my dog, and that made me think, oh, well, this is a sign that I'm gonna die, because seeing a dog, a cat, and a parrot with the sky, it made me think about heaven, and I'm like, oh God, this is not cool. I don't want to be looking at this. And I just kept staring at that for about 20 to 30 minutes until they finally started pulling me into the surgeon room. And the most funniest thing happened, and it's weird. It's really weird. I mean, it's weird for someone else to hear it, but for me, it's hard to explain. What made me feel confident that everything was going to be all right. And just so you guys know, my fiance, she made me feel confident everything was going to be all right. So did my mother. And what made me feel confident everything was going to be all right, or at least what I kept telling myself, was I have too much stuff to do before I go. And with that in my mind, I was like, yeah, I really don't think I'm going to die, because I still have so much left to do. I want to get married to my fiance. I want to have kids with her, and I want to complete my series, my book series. And that's pretty much the three things. After I do those three things, God can take me for everything I'm worth, because if I can, once I get those three things done and over with, I feel like I lived my life. So once that day came, and I was laying in that bed, all those thoughts just left my mind. I started feeling like, I really don't have any confidence anymore. I felt like that was it. This was my end. But when I got into that surgeon room and they started to lay me on my side, because, it's on my left side, and, they had to, it was actually very comfy too, the way they kind of laid me down. They put a pillow under my arm. They put two pillows underneath, one pillow underneath my legs and one in between my legs, and one very comfy pillow right next to my head. And when they laid me on my side, I saw something in front of me on the wall. And, you know, just seeing what I saw made me realize how, you know, I feel like everything was going to be okay. And that really shows how much this thing means to me for the fact that it made me feel like, yes, I am going to live another day. And what I saw was Spider-Man stickers. I saw about five of them in perfect view. Just like there was like two or three of them of where it's Spider-Man, but then there was a couple other ones that were the logo of Spider-Man. And I'm just looking at them like, this is a sign that everything's gonna be okay for me. And then next thing I know, I'm blacked out and I wake up pretty much, it felt like 2 seconds later, even though it was about an hour. So yeah, I'm doing okay. And what made everything a lot better was the fact that once I woke up and I was able to move, like I was actually getting closer to leaving the hospital, they pretty much, the woman who was, you know, watching over me, she was watching over a lot of people, I think. She pretty much told me that, you know, I have to pretty much relax for a week, as in no work, no heavy lifting, nothing like that for a week. And I'm just like, I'm fine with that. Somewhat, because I'm basically getting paid shit next week. But originally, they told me I had to be off for 3 to 4 days. So I requested Monday off, even though I already had Friday, Saturday, and Sunday off. For some reason, they gave me Thursday off as well. I don't know why. But they gave me those, I asked for those days off. But after hearing that, after I got out of the surgery, I had to call my job on Sunday. Well, I called Saturday, but I had to call Sunday again because I had to talk to my grocery manager. But I told him, you know, I'm not going to be able to come in until Friday night because I need at least 3 more days off. So that's another good thing. But yeah, I'm doing good. Friday, I'm going back so they can, so we can get, I guess so he can check my scar and we can get, hopefully we'll get results on what it was. So yeah, I just wanted to make this update video for you guys. And I'm finally glad I got this update video out. And to be honest, the main reason why I wanted to do this video is because I wanted to tell you guys that story about how seeing Spider-Man stickers actually made me feel confident that everything was going to be okay. Ooh, excuse me. So, with that being said, will see you guys again next time. And just so you guys know, I actually have an ice pack underneath my arm. So that's pretty much why I was adjusting, you know, my shirt and all that, because, you know, I don't have a bra underneath. But no, I have an ice pack and it's not really in a good position. But yeah, with that being said, I'll see you guys again next time.